that's behind me. There's my stack of favorite picture books, I promised you. So I loved picture books when I was a child, didn't you? In fact, even when I grew into junior high and high school, I still loved going back and reading all those stories that brought such special memories. And I want to share some of those with you today, because many of my favorite picture books, some of them are my kids' favorites, but many of them are my favorites. So you may not have heard of them. I am an old school book lover. So stay tuned for some awesome picture book recommendations. So I recently did a favorite read alouds video. Make sure you check that one out if you have not already. And you know what? Recording that video was not as easy as I made it look. Okay. In fact, it just happened because I didn't have the mic on. Those are the types of things you guys never see, because we YouTubers edit those things out so that you just think this is all easy peasy. If you like to laugh, you've got to check out this behind the scenes video of everything that just went wrong and created Rachel's horrible, terrible, very bad, no good day. It was awful, but I took my lemons and I made lemonade and it became a funny video. So check it out. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. In that read aloud video, I did say that I would be sharing my favorite picture books. I still love picture books, you guys. If I could have my son sit on my lap and let me read him a picture book, my 15-year-old son, mind you, I would do it, because it's a good picture book when both parent and child enjoy it. Can I get an amen? As I go through these, feel free to comment below what your favorite picture books are. I definitely have one that I would say is my number one favorite picture book of all time, because I loved it when I was a child. I wanted it read over and over and over again. And it was the one picture book that as soon as I found out I was gonna be a mother, I said, I need this picture book. I made sure my brothers had a copy for their children too. And it is just an overall family favorite for us. These picture book selections are in no particular order. The first one that I want to bring up, I don't even own, but I got it at the library. And every time I go to the library, I want to check it out because I love this book. And it is called The Circus Ship. I love this book because the idea about the book and the animals kind of being on a ship, and it's just a very unique plot, but it's a rhyming book, so it's a fun book, and it has fantastic illustrations. So check out The Circus Ship. It's probably at your local library. Okay, so of my kids' favorite picture books, they are going to tell you anything Mo Wellems. We have so many Mo Wellems books. I'm sure you've heard of them, but if you haven't, you need to get these books. This one might be our favorite. So we are in a book. It's the very first Mo Wellems book I ever bought for my kids, and I think it's still their favorite. And the reason that they like it, first of all, it's super easy to read for parents, so you can get through it quickly, so you could get through several Mo Wellems books. But it's also easy for your kids to read when they start reading. And the illustrations are very, very simple. Here's the thing that I love about this particular book is Elephant and Piggy figure out, hey, we're in a book, we're being read. Let's make the reader say this word. And then they make the reader say this word and they start laughing and the kids just think this is so fun. But when they get to the book, Elephant and Piggy start panicking. Oh no, they're on page 46, they're on page 47. It's kind of a very much more interactive book than the other Mo Wellems books. So if you only get one Mo Wellems book, get this one. But he's also, besides the Elephant and Piggy books, he's a lot of pigeon books, like The Pigeon Wants a Puppy, Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus. Super, super fun books. Llama Llama books we love because they're rhyming, and Llama Llama, Mama Drama, all that stuff. I just love the rhyming books. So again, more books you've probably heard of. Anytime the library has a Llama Llama book, I always check those out. Okay, I have a feeling that, I didn't even think about this before, but I have a feeling that most of my favorite books are going to be rhyming. This one, yeah, this one kind of rhymes. A Fly Went By, this is an old school copy, you can tell. Man, if they look like they're old, I'm like a sucker for the old books. I get a lot of my used books from a used bookstore that I have very close by to me where they sell all kinds of used books for a quarter, but I also order from ThriftBooks. If it's a specific book that I want, I have a link to ThriftBooks below. But A Fly Went By is one of those like causation books. So A Fly Went By because the fly was being chased by a frog, and the frog was actually running from the cat. So it's a rhyming book, and eventually you realize there's this long, long, long string that started with the fly, but everything is being chased by something else. The fly ran away in fear of the frog, who ran from the cat, who ran from the dog and the pig and the cows, they all ran, and then came the fox, who ran from the man. So it's a super, super fun book. Your kids will love it. It's kind of like, it's not a Dr. Seuss book. It's written by Mike McClintock, but it's kind of like Dr. Seuss-ish. Okay, so the next three books I have, these, I do not know if you would be able to find these in the library. You might be able to find them like on a ThriftBooks, or if you ever go to a used bookstore or a garage sales, this is what you need to know. So these are three of my favorite books, okay, from my own childhood. So this one, Miss Susie, I have several copies of these because you guys, I have found them at garage sales and I recognize them and I pick them up for my kids so that my kids will each have their own copy to give to their kids or to read to their kids. But Miss Susie is a squirrel and her squirrel was raided by other mean squirrels, and so she was forced out of her home in this tree, and she found this house that had a dollhouse in it, and she inside the dollhouse, she cleaned it up and made the house her own, and then these toy soldiers moved in and she took care of the toy soldiers, and then finally it came out the reason she's living in the dollhouse is because these other mean squirrels took over her house. So the toy soldiers went to Miss Susie's house and saved the day and ran the mean squirrels out. But it's a super fun story. This one, Never Tease a Weasel. I mean, I think these things are copyright. Let me see. This is copyright 1964. But again, I have three copies of this book because I found them at garage sales. This one is a short book, but it's a rhyming book, and it says like you can do all these things, okay? You can give a mule a pool with some jaunty swimming trunks. So it's got all kinds of animals in it. Send a case of Spanish lace to a pair of lady skunks. You could give a fish a dish for her favorite seaweed stew. Send three frogs some sailing togs and a yachting cap or two, but never tease a weasel. Now I can't be more precise. A weasel will not like it, and teasing isn't nice. So the theme of the book is teasing isn't nice. But they're using all of these fun animal illustrations, and again, the rhyming. My last favorite from this is The Runaway Horse. It's about a horse that's on a merry-go-round. He doesn't like going in circles, so he eventually gets off the merry-go-round and runs away, but finds out that life is not easier outside the merry-go-round, and he ends up chipped up. So this is him escaping. He ends up chipped up and not maintained at all. He tries to be a real horse, but he's not a real horse. It kind of has some Christmassy themes in it and snow, so you could consider this a Christmas book, although it's not, it's like really a Christmas book. But in the end, you see, he ends up like all yucky and not maintained and realized that his position on the merry-go-round was replaced with another horse. So he's just starting to give up, but then the merry-go-round guy finds him and fixes him up, and he gets his place back on the merry-go-round. So grass is not always greener on the other side is the theme of this book. So these three books together, this is why I'm telling you this. Let's see if you can see this. Parents Magazine Press. If you are ever at a used bookstore or a garage sale and you see books of similar size, hardback, and they say Parents Magazine Press, and you look at the copyright and they're like from the 60s. Let's see. Tease a Weasel was from 64. Miss Susie was from 64. And The Runaway Horse here is also from the 60s and updated in the 70s. So I have a ton of these books because when my mom was a young parent, she was in this subscription where the parent magazine, they sent you a new book every single month. So she was like in that book club. But all of our parent magazine books that we have are excellent. So Parent Magazine Press, copyright 60s and 70s, are probably going to be fantastic stories. Our next favorite is The Old Man Who Loved Cheese. And this was a favorite of one of my nieces. So I was introduced to this at her high school graduation because her family just talked about how she wanted this book read over and over and over. She practically had it memorized. And so I got it for my kids, and it's another rhyming book. And it's about an old man who loved cheese so much he started to smell like cheese, and he started to bother his neighbors, and he eventually went on trial, or they were trying to get him to give up cheese, and he just couldn't give up cheese. So this is a fun book. All right, another favorite is The Giving Tree. This is a Shel Silverstein book. I like this tree because it's provoking. You know, the tree gave and gave and gave until the tree couldn't give anymore. First, you know, it gave an apple, it gave shade. Then this boy just kept coming back to get more from the tree. He cut limbs off to make things. See, he carved hearts into the tree. This is not a rhyming book. Eventually, he got so much out of the tree, all he had left was a stump to sit on. But I feel like this has got a couple lessons in it. One about being a taker, and two about being a giver. And what are the biblical applications that you could draw from this book? I think there are some. So I like that book a lot. Another favorite, this was given at my son's baby shower. So here's a tradition. If you have a new mom in your life, a lot of times my friends, in lieu of a baby card, they will ask people to bring a favorite child's book. Because, you know, a lot of those cards can be $5, $6, $7. You could get a book for that and write a message inside the book. So one of my friends gave me this book, Harry the Dirty Dog Treasury. So there are four Harry the Dirty Dog stories in here, and they're all super cute. I had never heard of Harry the Dirty Dog before she gave this to me, but that was her favorite childhood story. So these are text copyright 1956. You guys see, we love the old school stories. They're just so creative. And there's no agenda with them, just good character stories. But there's the colors and the Harry the Dirty Dog. He's always getting the mischief. Roses for Harry. So this has No Roses for Harry, Harry by the Sea. Highly recommend. Okay, so the next two books I have are by the same author, and it is newer. So this one is a newer one. You could probably find these in the bookstore right now. And at your library. And that is Rosie Revere Engineer. Is this rhyming? Why, yes, it is rhyming. So this book is about Rosie, a little girl who just loved to create things, and she ran into some trouble, and she started to give up on her dream of becoming this great engineer. And then she had an aunt who came along and helped her. And her aunt revealed that she too used to be just like Rosie. So this is one of those inspiring tales to keep that imagination alive in your children and to encourage some of the crazy things that they want to do, because you never know what they could turn into someday. And Rosie creates something pretty good in this book. But it might even make some parents shed a tear. So this is a fantastic book. So that's by Andrea Beatty. And she also wrote this book, Happy Birthday, Madame Chapeau. I love this book. My kids love this book because I always, whenever I read it to them, I try to do it in the French accent, as much as I can do a French accent, Madame Chapeau. This is about Madame Chapeau, a hat maker, and she makes all these really cool hats for everybody. So she's kind of a giver, right? And then it's her birthday, and everybody comes around and does something nice for her. But it's a super fun book with a lot of great illustrations. And there are some characters, like this is, I think this is Iggy Peck. So Andrea Beatty has several books like Rosie Revere Engineer. I can't think of the other names, but this is one of the characters from one of her other books. She has her characters, they kind of make sneak peeks into some they kind of sneak into some of the other books. But here's an example of some of the illustrations. Just, I like the Andrea Beatty books. You Are Special by Max Lucado. So this is about, this is kind of like a, I always say allegory when I say it's a story, but it has like a deeper spiritual meaning, kind of not like a parable allegory. I don't know what you would call that. But this book, this story is about the Wemmicks, and they were people who, if they were good or people liked them, they would get stars. And if people didn't like what they did, they would get dots. And these stickers, they just stuck to them. And so everybody could see whether you had stars or whether you had dots, and you couldn't get rid of them. So this, the main character of this story would only get dots. He would never get stars. So he was always, everybody was saying they were disappointed in him. He wasn't very popular. And then one day he met his maker, because they were like wooden people. He met his maker, and the maker started taking off all the dots and said, it doesn't matter what everybody else thinks of you. This is how I made you. And then when he went back into town, so he had a new perspective. Well, his maker was pleased with him, right? So how does God view us? Who does God say that you are? That's what matters. It doesn't matter what other people are. And then when they tried to stick dots on him, they wouldn't stick. So this is a great spiritual lesson again, and a fun story. Now I'm going to get into, I'm almost done, but I want to get into some of the old school stories that do not neglect, because the old school fairy tales, the old school stories that probably our parents grew up with, they are just fantastic. Our kids need to know these stories. And then I'm going to share with you one Christmas book recommendation. It is my favorite Christmas picture book, and then my favorite all-time picture book, The Three Billy Goats Gruff. Don't neglect this story. I love this as a kid. This book that I have here is one of those circa 1950s, 1956. I love it. I just love how, I feel like I'm holding history right here when I have these old books. I will never, ever give them up. I think I got this at a garage sale. I'm not sure that this one was mine. But The Three Billy Goats Gruff, remember, is about a bridge and a troll, and the goats were trying to cross the bridge, and the troll wouldn't let them, and the troll was going to eat them. And so the three billy goats were brothers, and what happened there. The Velveteen Rabbit. This actually might have been my favorite fairy tale story that when I was a kid, not my favorite picture book, but my favorite story to be told, about a little boy who loved his stuffed Velveteen Rabbit, but then the little boy got scarlet fever, and that rabbit was there to comfort him through that time. But with scarlet fever, once the sickness was gone, they had to burn everything to get rid of that disease. And so the boy's poor rabbit, who had been there to comfort him through that sickness, ended up burning, which is so sad. It's kind of like Toy Story, right? When Andy was done with his toys. But the rabbit ended up turning into a real rabbit so he could still look at, because he fulfilled his stuffed rabbit destiny, so he could still keep an eye on the boy. Okay, and then just old school fairy tales. So this particular book I have has Mother Goose selections in it. It has a lot of Grimm's fairy tales. So the classic Jack and the Beanstalk, your classic Princess and the Pea, your history of Tom Thumb. Let's see, Hansel and Gretel, The Emperor's New Clothes. I mean, some of these have been made into newer books, but you've got to introduce your kids to the Grimm's fairy tales and just these things that our ancestors grew up on. They have good moral themes to them. They have good lessons. And you can always tie it back to the spiritual. My favorite Christmas book has nothing to do with Jesus, because obviously there's a lot of good Christian Christmas books. This is just a fun Christmas book that maybe you've never heard of, and it is called Mr. Willoughby's Christmas Tree. I love this book. The first time I ever got it from the library, I was like, that was a fantastic story. So Mr. Willoughby, you can see he got a Christmas tree that was too tall, so he had to chop off the top, and then somebody else took the top, to put it in their space, and that top of that their tree was a little too tall, so they had to chop off the top. And so the top of the Christmas tree just kept getting passed down to fit all these many spaces. So this Christmas tree ended up becoming a Christmas tree for many, many, many households. This is a fun story. And does it rhyme? Let's see.
Yes, it does.
Baxter the butler was called on in haste to chop off the tree, though it seemed quite a waste. I love rhyming books. And then my number one all-time favorite children's book, picture book. This is an old school folk tale. In fact, I'm gonna look at the copyright date on this. 1968 copyright. Tiki Tiki Tembo. This is like a folk tale about why the Chinese give their children very short names. It's a super fun story. So Tiki Tiki Tembo was actually shortened. This mother had two sons, and her first son was the most beloved, most fantastic, best son in the world. And his name was Tiki Tiki Tembo No Sa Rembo Chari Bari Ruchi Peri Pembo. That was his full name because he was the most beloved and most honored son. And her second son, his name was Chin, which meant little or nothing. And so this is kind of a tale. If you've ever had children who have sibling rivalry, I know I've seen this in my extended family. My nieces and nephews think that their oldest sibling is the firstborn, the golden child, the most beloved. This is the book for families like that. But in the end, Tiki Tiki Tembo No Sa Rembo Chari Bari Ruchi Pit Peri Pembo, his name ended up causing him harm. And so this is the story about how his little brother, who was more insignificant seemingly, right, saved his life, but they had to shorten Tiki Tiki Tembo's name because of what happened in this tale. And then after that, the Chinese just always thought it best to give their children little short names so that this would never happen again. So this was my favorite story growing up. And I know this is in the library. It's in my public library, so it's probably in yours too. If you did not see my read aloud video, my favorite read alouds video, check out this. And if you want to see the behind the scenes of recording the read aloud video, check out this one. And I hope you laugh. Bye.